पुत्रस्य गतिर नास्ति.
अपुत्रस्य गतिर नास्ति, राइट? दे हैव सेड, दे टोल्ड इट परफेक्टली करेक्ट, बट यू हर्ड इट रॉन्गली. ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಹಾಗೆ ಆಗದಿದ್ದರೆ ಮುಕ್ತಿ ಇಲ್ಲ. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಗೈನ್, ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಗೈನ್, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮುಕ್ತಿ. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವು ರಾಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಡಿಡ್. ಅವರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ actually seeking liberation, everybody in that country is seeking liberation. So what is, I don't know what, that's why this Kumbh Mela is there, right? What is Kumbh Mela? Everybody wants mukti. Okay, liberation is our past time in our country, full time past time. Full time past time, everybody asks, I want to get rid of samsara, I want to book mukti. Okay, everywhere in the world there are big jatras happens. Some fun, some automobile jatra, some mobile phone jatra, people, lakhs of people come. But nowhere in the world, 3 crore people come for mukti. So that shows how deeply mukti is there in our blood. And we understood properly. Makkala agadidare mukti na. That's why we have produced 1 billion children. Keep on producing children, because mukti will come because of the putra. That too, female child will not work. Only male child. Did you understand the paradox? So it has nothing to do with the child. That's why Upanishad will tell again. That's like Upanishad called Kaivalya Upanishad. Na karmana, na prajaya, na dhanena, tyage, naike, mukti, amrutattva manushu. Na karmana, na prajaya, na dhanena, tyage, naike, amrutattva manushu. This is the teaching of Upanishad. Because they know that you start thinking that you want children for mukti, which is wrong. Na karmana means through your actions you cannot get mukti. Whatever actions you do, you cannot get mukti, because mukti is not a result of action. Na prajaya, by producing more children, especially male children, you will not get mukti. Then you will get suffering. Okay? But if you become like child, or you become child, then you'll get mukti. That's the meaning of it. You understand? So those who don't understand Kannada, okay? So I'm just translating a very bad translation of Hindi in Kannada, because that words have that power in that. So, right? English I'll tell, no? So there is a saying in Kannada, okay? Without children, you cannot get liberation. Okay, then our country is seeking liberation. No? We have produced one, we have become the biggest popular country. That to male children. So it's a wrong understanding. So the Kannada, the words are very simple. So it is not without children you get mukti. It is without becoming like a child you'll get mukti. So the key to mukti is like becoming like a child. Huh? ಸೊ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಅಂದರೆ ಆನಂದ, ಆ ಮಗುವಿನ ಆನಂದ ನಿಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಾಗ ಮುಕ್ತಿ. ದಿ ಬ್ಲಿಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮುಕ್ತಿ. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವು ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಮುಕ್ತಿ. ದ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ನೋ ಡಿಸೈರ್, ಫುಡ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್, ದೆನ್ ಸಮ್ ದಿ ಇಟ್ ವೆಟ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಲೋತ್, ಇಲ್ ಕ್ರೈ, ಬಟ್ ಅದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಅದರ್ ಡಿಸೈರ್. ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ನೋ, ಅಬ್ಸಲ್ಯೂಟ್ಲಿ ನೋ ಡಿಸೈರ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಡಿಸೈರ್, ಬಟ್ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್. But here the list is very big. I already wrote the big list. Masala dosa, job, grandchildren. You understand? So this is the state of mukti or liberation. To discover the child in you. Understand? To rediscover, if you rediscover the child in you, then it is called Jeevan Mukti, liberation. If you die as an old man or old woman, gone case, again you'll have to take birth to get this. you failed, again come back from the, again start beginning. Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi janani, jatare shayanam, because what was your childhood, you forgot. So I became again become the child to learn it.
Again, same place.
Same place. lesson start from beginning again.
And you hear the lesson. The first, somebody will say, you're this body and you belong to this family. Seeing from another point of view, it's small child. He's very prone for contagious diseases.
I'll come to that, right? So, contagious?
Diseases, Bharatan. And the son of Makkalage, Sankram. So this was the first contagious disease.
I'll tell so many contamination diseases will come now. So from here to here, what has contamination happens, I'll tell you. Right? You are right about that. First contamination is eye virus.
First infection.
That's called virus, eye virus. Okay, eye virus is introduced to the child. By whom?
Parents.
Now they don't feel, they feel jealous of the child. So blissful, I am struggling, I am going earning. The father says, I have to work every day. Mother says, I have to work around the house. This child is so blissful, let me make him like me. Okay. So that's where the bliss means becoming like, again this. If you don't become by the time of death, again the God will say, tell me lessons again. Okay? So lesson you are taking again and again to learn how it is like this throughout your life. So repeat with me. Punarapi Jananam. Punarapi Maranam. Punarapi Jananam. Punarapi Maranam. Punarapi Janani. Jatare Shayanam. Iha Samsare. Bahu Dussare. Kripaya Pare. Pahi Murare. So you be again and again take birth. You think it's because of karma? No. You are taking birth to learn what it is like to be like this. Throughout your life. Okay? That's called mukti. And that is called bliss. Okay? So now, how it is like to be like this? Question. I have not seen this because I have forgotten now. So at least you have children. Right? But you get a sample of that every day. Sample. The sample of this you get when you sleep. Okay? When you are in deep sleep, you are like this only. Almost. No worries, no tension, no stress, no wife, no husband, no family, no job. Okay? No grandchildren, no great-great-grandchildren also. So that is a sample of bliss. To understand what is bliss for you. But that is not the purpose. That means come to a resort and sleep for 24 hours a day. No. Then it would have been very easy. You don't have to come here and pay the fees. Take some sleeping tablets and do that. You have to be in that state while walking, talking, working, talking, working, in this state. That is called Jivanmukti. Are we getting somewhere? Madam? Understanding?
Yes.
So can we be like a child, even when we are performing all our roles and responsibilities in life?
Is it possible, sir?
It is possible. That's what is Jivanmukti. Actually, that is wrongly understood by spiritual practitioners and twisted and given various names, branded and marketed as something. The real Jivanmukti is like this all the time, not sleeping only. Maguagi jivana madbeko. Yalla jawabdari avan bhavisbeko. Jawabdari nodi hogi mukti alla. Jawabdari iddu maguvina hage irabeko. We'll come to that innocence, right? So, if you have a wrong understanding of mukti, please understand, this is called mukti. If you don't attain it when you are alive, you are condemned to repeat this cycle. Is this much clear at all? Okay. So, okay, I have 15 more minutes. Are you getting somewhere, madam? So this is what people are seeking in the name of liberation. This is what they are seeking for in the name of mukti. But what's happening is, there's so much of confusion is there in the air, they don't understand what they are trying to get.
And sir, how to connect with the other people in this world, right? That is the biggest...
We'll come to that. We'll repair everything. Provided you give me time. So, first you understand what we are seeking. This is what is seeking, whether it's a monk or Buddha or sannyasi or housewife or anybody is finally seeking this in their life. Okay? Anybody has a doubt or question in this? So now, I will ask the same question. I am blissful when? What will you answer? When I am like a child. That is the only answer. Not going away from samsara. Not running away from samsara. Anywhere you are there, you have a mind of an innocent child. Over.
Or you are living with children.
1 billion children you have produced, sir, and still we are going for mukti. Sir, are you aware, sir? India is the largest country, the most populous country in the world. We are overtaking China also.
Sir, what I'm getting is not that.
Sir, what about Shukamani? 16.
No, like this. He didn't become like this.
With children means when you are interacting with children or teaching children.
No, that's what I'm saying. That's where conditions apply.
Okay.
So please understand, mukti means conditions removed. So that's what I'm saying. When you are with children, you will get a glimpse of happiness, which is a ray of bliss.
Okay.
Don't confuse ray with the totality. Absolutely.
Shri said, I am like a child who refuses to grow.
Now, except for beard. A child with a beard. Is this much clear to all?
Yes.
So now I'll question, ask the question. When you are the child and here you are 50 plus, so 1 minus, let's say, before 1 year old,
9 months.
So what happened from here to here?
Desires increase.
Let's say
lifetime.
Yeah.
What really happened?
Recognition.
Yeah. Recognition. See, it was like a king in a small kingdom, a particular water source was poisoned, and whoever drank became mad. So the king was the only one who had a bottle and he drank from that water. Everyone said, this guy is mad, we are all okay.
Yeah.
So he finally threw this and started
drinking that.
And started dancing like others.
Okay, you are right. So now, you cannot be in a mad world and be sane also. The child is born sane, but he enters into a mad world. And you cannot remain the sanity, it will not be possible. Right? So what happens now from here to here, the child, you can help with computer analogy, computer. So all of you have laptop and computer? Right? So there are some programs and something called virus. What does this virus do? It keeps on corrupting, right? Who introduced the virus into computer? Did computer introduce it?
The world.
Somebody in the world didn't like this computer, it introduced a virus. And by the way, do you know where the first virus came in the world? If computer virus came in the world, from where? Guess, make a guess. 100 rupees price for 100 rupees price for somebody makes a right guess.
From manufacturer itself.
100 rupees price for somebody who tells where did the first virus in the world came from?
India.
Parents.
From my
parents.
Computer virus. The first computer virus came from Pakistan. Can you believe it? So what happened was, the computer started coming to the market. Okay, so then a lot of American soldiers were going to Afghanistan for war, and the soldiers will come to Pakistan for shopping. Shopping what? Pirated software. Okay, so what software costs? That time software was very costly, $30, $40 per piece in America. So they, in the Pakistan streets of Lahore, they used to sell $1. That software, copy. The soldiers used to buy from Pakistan streets. One smart guy, very intelligent guy, he thought, these people who are buying software doing a sin. He is selling the software, but buying software is sin.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful.
And he said, God has to punish these people.
Not us.
He is selling software $1 is not a sin, but buying software at $1 is sin, and those who are buying should be punished. So that's why he created the first virus. They created, they're called Ali brothers. They created the first virus and introduced it to the pirated software which is being sold in Pakistan, and from Pakistan it spread to other part of the world. First virus was invented in Pakistan. Okay, so now this virus will play havoc in the computer system. But for the child, the first virus is introduced by the parents. The first virus name is called, okay? So now you tell to your neighbor, okay? I'll say that, okay? The first virus name is?
The name of the child.
No, you turn to your neighbor and say, I'll tell, repeat, please, first virus name is? Your name. You tell your name. No, you tell your name. You tell your name. That's the first virus. That is the first virus introduced into your system. So now you tell your name is the first virus which gone into. You understand? Everybody said complete this? Complete virus. If you don't tell about this, utter about this virus will not go. It will stay in the system. I am doing a, what is the antivirus software I am giving. So, are you clear? So everybody repeated, anybody has not found the virus? You have found the virus? You have told her? Madam, what about you, sir? So everybody found the virus. Are you clear? Vasu?
Yes.
So Akshi is another name.
Vasu and Vani are the vaccines.
Vaccines. So, first virus name is called your name. Okay? And our ancestors knew this first virus called your name has to be removed from your mind. They knew it. And they gave you antivirus. Okay? You know what is antivirus? Don't know. Everybody has been given. For all of you have been given. Okay? All of you have been given by antivirus name by myth. Your generation, earlier generation. God's name, you said, they said, repeat the God's name. So that your virus will go. Okay, so let us chant. Om Namah Shivaya.
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 Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Shivaya Namah Om.
Shivaya Namah Om.
So they gave that antivirus to you from the generation. They didn't tell antivirus, they didn't have the virus name called antivirus. Okay? But their purpose was, the virus is already there, your name is there. So you have to replace with a better name, God's name. So you chanted. They told you to chant 24 hours a day. You started chanting while cooking, chanting. While watching TV, chanting. While doing work, chanting. Chanting, chanting, chanting all the time. It became a mechanical habit, like a tape recorder. Okay? Then I asked madam, madam, are you chanting God's name? Yes. I am chanting God's name 1,000,000 times. Who is there important? I am. Virus is already there. Before God's name, I am there. The God's name is given to remove that I am, the virus. So now what became important? I am. Okay? So you chanted. So you chanted Om Namah Shivaya. There you are sleeping. Sir, what's your name?
Sridhar.
Huh? Sridhar. Sridhar chanted. Not offending, okay. Sridhar chanted Om Namah Shivaya 1,000,000,000 times. Very great. What I'm saying, sir? Switch on. Very great devotee, practitioner. A great achievement. So now, Sridhar sleeping. While waking hours and dreaming also he chants. Then sleeping. So I go to Sridhar. She is a great devotee of Shiva. Om Namah Shivaya. Sridhar is Om Namah Shivaya. Sridhar, Which is deeper, the virus or antivirus?
No, virus is
antivirus, God's name has been given. But even in sleep, the virus is so deep, in sleep you will not respond to Om Namah Shivaya, you will respond to Sridhar only.
there is a disease called sleeping sickness. So this is the sleeping sickness.
So are you clear?
Yes,
this, the myth was, the earlier our paper thought, this guy has a problem being given the childhood, the name. So to remove that dependence on I am that, you chant God's name. That was given as antivirus. That's the truth. Now, what is the reality? I am Sridhar. I have chanted God's name 1,000,000,000 times. So, what have you chanted, sir? No, not wasted. Every time people are chanting God's name, he thinks, Sridhar is chanting God's name. I am Sridhar chanting means. The virus and antivirus are coexisting. Now they are becoming harmonious. They are living together. So, have you understood the spiritual practices?
Yes.
Madam, clear? So, that's only beginning. There's a whole lot of new viruses are coming. The whole lot. They don't come with a single. They are coming with a family. So this child, now first virus he got, now he is ready for further programming. So the child is very innocent, right? And it accepts anything told authoritatively. Who is the authority for the child?
Parents.
Grandparents. Now more than parents and grandparents, the television, mobile phone. Okay. So now, this child is very innocent. So everybody started dumping their old programs into this guy.
Yeah.
First program is dumped by mother. Mother program started entering into child. Are you understanding? Mother started her program. Her suffering is she is suffering. Beta, tum bade hokar engineer mat bano. Dekho apna baap ko. बेटा कभी इंजीनियरिंग मत सोचो देखो ये क्या हालत है सो वन बाय वन दीज पीपल स्टार्टेड डंपिंग देयर प्रोग्राम द चाइल्ड डजंट नो इनोसेंट इट थिंक्स मदर इज गॉड ओनली ओके व्हाट आर मदर सेज हाँ मम्मी यस मम्मी सो हाउ मेनी प्रोग्राम्स मदर विल डंप फर्स्ट अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर द मदर So, is mother blissful?
No.
If mother is blissful, will she dump the program into the child's head? Huh? So the mother is suffering. She has a lot of bundle. Now she starts transferring those what she has learned in life. She doesn't have any bad will for the child. She says, my learning life is this, you don't repeat this. And the child memory is very fresh. Fresh DRAM. How many gigabytes? Terabytes of data free memory. Are you clear? The child is being dumped with the newer and newer programs by the mother, the father, okay, the grandparents, the school, the society, friends.
With each generation, the school, especially the school programming.
Everything, but first program is father, mother.
Yeah.
Have you heard of one of these chantings called Madalasa song?
Madalasa, yeah.
Madalasa? No, 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 not Madrasa, boy. There is a Mandu, there is a Markandeya Purana. Okay? Markandeya Purana, okay, if you get an opportunity, I don't know whether you can display it, it is nice. There is a Markandeya Purana, there was a key queen called Madalasa. The queen called Madalasa, okay, had four children. And she was a Jnani, enlightened queen. Please understand, enlightenment doesn't require to become a monk. Wherever you are, whoever you are, you can become enlightened, provided you know how. The child was born and the child was given a name by the king. And immediately the child's name was given by the king, the child started crying. And mother Madalasa, who is an enlightened one, she understood the problem of the child. She said, "Don't worry, my dear son, you are not the name. You are not the body. And the education of Atmajnana was given to a born baby of 7 days by the mother. That is the enlightened mother. That was the country called India, Bharata Desha. Where a newborn baby in the house was taught Atmajnana. Now, for Atmajnana, it's become an adult education. Old age, pastime, retirement, post-retirement. Okay? The country called Bharata, there's a name, it is called Bharata. Bha means knowledge. Rata means they are blissful all the time. Because of knowledge, every child born in the country was blissful. That's why it's called Bharata. And education started with the mother. Now education starts with the mother. Now also, what education? 1980 Hindi songs. Kya hua? So now the programming of the child has started. Mother, the father, okay, and also please understand. The child is innocent and he is looking at the mother or father like this because he is so small. He knows he is very small. Weakness is small. And mother and father are authority. So what mother, father, the family members tell, it becomes go deep into your whole mind. How deep? Okay. And most of it is their suffering and their experiences they are dumping into you in various ways. They don't have to tell explicitly. While working, your mother is sad, the child observes it. While father is coming, he is unhappy, the child observes it. Child doesn't not only listen, it observes, learns. So all this programming has gone into the child. Okay? Are you aware the growth of a brain of a child? Anybody knows?
The first 5 years, I think it learns maybe 90% of all that.
So our child's brain, okay, grows more than 50% when in the mother's womb from between the age of 6 months to 9 months. Very rapid growth. The mother is listening something that will go deep inside. That's why Abhimanyu and other people were able to learn the warfare. In India, there was a system called prenatal education. The child was born, child which were born had education in the mother's womb. And that's where the country like India produced some children who were born enlightened. Vamadeva Rishi was born with the mothers from the mother womb enlightened. Shukamuni, the prenatal education. Now in India, postnatal education started. Old Hindi songs. Okay. So now all these are being dumped. And for the child, is looking for authority, right? See, when we tell something with authority, that goes deep inside. Who is the authority for the child? The mother, the father, the grandparents. And with the authority, they are pushing their programs into the child. Please understand, there is no bad intention. It's only that they are also ignorant. Okay. Now this forms the foundation. By the time child is growth is grown at the age of 5 years, 80% growth has happened, brain. And deepest foundation you already laid by the programming. Okay. From 8 years up to 5 years, the child is exposed to the family. This is the deepest programming. So then between the age of 5 and 9, the brain goes to 90%. It goes to 90% growth. So here the programming happens by the school bus, the children, family, the teachers. So my relative is there, my brother. His son, from kindergarten, he was put into primary school. In primary school, they have to travel by bus. Okay? So within 1 week, the child started saying, I want to commit suicide. Okay, I want to commit suicide. In house, they don't speak about this suicide. Suicide word is not uttered. Then these people analyzed. What is happening is the child is traveling in the school bus. In the school bus, some children are coming from a disturbed family. The disturbed family, every day the word is, I want to commit suicide. The child are saying that. This guy is saying that. So the virus spreads. And it spreads at a very young age where your mind is very, very fresh. Learning is very fast. So now, parents, grandparents, the classmates. By the time 9 years, your basic program is already set. Okay? So between 9 years and 18 years, another 10% growth will happen. So now the growth, the 10% also, there is hormonal growth will happen in that. Now the focus is on the opposite sex. Somewhere the sex, female sex and male sex. The programming happens because of sex. So by the age of 18, your complete development has happened. The basic development. After that, whatever learning skills, how to fulfill that? Are you clear? So your entire spiritual journey now, please understand, what is it? Deprogramming is called spiritual journey. Come out of this programming is called spiritual journey. Getting out of the programming is called spiritual journey. So that with all the suffering in life or suffer this thing, you are again back to your original shape before you die. So there is a policy, no? Return policy, right? What is the return policy? So if you buy some goods from the market, right? If you don't like it, you go and directly give to the shopkeeper. Shopkeeper, right? So what shopkeeper will do?
Replaces.
He will take it back and replace it. Returns. Okay? 1 month return policy, have you heard of this? Huh? But there's a condition applied. What is that? No damage has happened. So this child, full damage has happened, and he returns to God after death. The God says, return. I don't accept anything damaged condition. Give me back the original condition. Then no return. This is called bhakti. Are you clear, madam? Understood, sir? Okay, because the mukti has become taken various names and shapes in the religion, in the monks, everybody is twisted it to their advantage. This is the mukti. How you came from God, you go back to God, you are free. If you go back to God in a damaged condition, you are returned. Are you clear? So now you understood the meaning of Punarapi Jananam? Punarapi Jananam. Punarapi Maranam. Punarapi Janani. Jatare Shayanam. Then you are in a damaged condition. So can you go back in the original shape? That is the entire question of spirituality and religion. So people have converted it, polished it, and made it in such a way you can't recognize what is the intention of the whole thing. Is it clear, madam?
But I'm thinking, is it possible with so much of conditioning to go back?
First, have you heard of this? This is the first time you are hearing it. Isn't it?
Yes.
Isn't it? Have you heard of this understanding any time?
No.
This is the first time you are hearing it. And so, anything to happen, you need somebody who knows it. A doctor is required. Experienced doctor is required for you to take the path. That experienced person is called Guru. provided he has understood what it is. Right now what's happening is, they are also in the same cycle. They are also trying to get rid of their program. They are programming, they are transferring their program to Shishyas. Okay, can we break for some time? Fine.
enough material for sorry.